Hello there, all you beautiful thrill seekers. My name is Ghost Shadonk Stubborn, but built for theme parks, and welcome to Ghost Chat YouTube channel. Hello there, guys. My name is Ghost Shadonk Stubborn, but built for theme parks, and welcome to a theme park newsroom discussion video. This is all about RMC and Blackpool Pleasure Beach. Now, this video is very specific. Pacific? Specific! I'll say that again. It was very specific, this video, because I wanted to see what kind of RMC elements would be added on a conversion of any of the three main thrilling Blackpool Pleasure Beach wooden roller coasters. You hear what I say? The thrilling ones. We're going to leave out the fourth one, Blue Flyer, aka the Zipper Dipper. We're going to leave that one out because that's more of a family one. So we're going to leave that one alone, and we're going to focus on the three other ones. Now, that is, of course, the Nickelodeon Streak, the Grand National, and the Big Dipper. Now, of course, this isn't saying that Blackpool Pleasure Beach is going to RMC any of their wooden coasters. However, I personally do believe that I'm quite interested to see what kind of elements they would include if they were told, right, we want to redo this wooden coaster, or this one, what can you do? And I sort of wanted to guess what kind of elements we could see on an RMC conversion on each of the three wooden coasters, and sort of what names and themes we could see as well. Even though the names and themes aren't in the title, we kind of want to see that. But before we get started with all of that, make sure you like the video if you've loved it, comment down below your thoughts and opinions, subscribe to the channel, click the notification bell so you never miss another thrilling YouTube video. Also, guys, if you go into the description down below, you can find Twitter, TikTok, Instagram, and Snapchat links for the channel. Make sure you go check that out. And also submit your video ideas using the Google Forms link, also linked in the description down below the video. Also, guys, make sure you stay tuned for more brilliant content coming over the next few weeks. We've got wonderful content to come, and I'm sure you're going to absolutely flip your lid for this content. And for now, guys, let's have a look exactly what's going on and what elements I think should be on the RMC conversions of three of the main thrilling Blackpool Pleasure Beach wooden roller coasters. So to talk about the wooden coasters, we have to know your wooden coasters, and we're going to go the newest last. So we're going to go with the oldest one first. Now, this is the Big Dipper. It opened in 1923, so in 2023, it's going to be 100 years old. Ooh, can't wait. Now, this has a length of 3,300 feet, a height of 60 feet, a duration of 2 minutes 30, and it was modified in 1936 by Charlie Page and Joe Emberton. The original layout made a greater than 90 degree bend when the small bend under the big one is today. It extended east to where Space Invader is today. Of course, that's known as the Big Pizza Kitchen in Nickelodeon Land. Roughly following the route of the big one's lift hill and station, and at that time this was bordering the southern edge of the park. When the land was to the south that was acquired, the Big Dipper made use of this land as demonstrated by the present layout. So what elements could I see on a Big Dipper transformation? Well, I think first of all you've got to take into account the rides nearby the Big Dipper. Infusion, Icon, the Big One, Steeplechase, you got Nickelodeon Street near to it as well, because obviously it's near Steeplechase, so it's right opposite Nickelodeon Street's element that's sort of off shot, should we say. But you've got to take into account other rides. I think what we're looking here is an out and back coaster. Utilize the Big Dipper sort of tower, should we say. Use the tower to its advantage. And the reason why I say use the tower to its advantage is because I think they could do what they sort of did on, so you know where, you know, Untamed at Wallaby Holland, the Robin Hood conversion, and they sort of did that outer bend turn where you sort of going on the outer edge, so you say, as you're turning back into going to the lift hill. I'd like to see one of those outer turns off the top of the lift hill. I'd like to see you go up the lift hill and you sort of do one of those outer turns that sort of does like an outer edge look, sort of looking down at the rest of the park. Turn back and go down the 90 degree drop, and you can utilize some of the Big Dipper's original layout. You could literally do like the nice hills, maybe turn one or two of them into inversions, maybe a zero G stall and a zero G roll. It would be lovely, wouldn't it? And then you can utilize the sort of area where Steeplechase is. You could even maybe have to demolish Steeplechase to incorporate this and include a couple of layouts, maybe one of those double reverse banking hills. Maybe we could see a nice big overbank turn that looks like an inversion. that would be nice. I think Big Dipper, I have to point out straight away that it is definitely the least of the three to get RMC because of the interaction with the other rides around it. So I'd like to see, that's probably the least of the RMC conversions that I'd see, but I'd like to see Big Dipper utilize those elements, kind of like a zero-G stall, zero-G roll, remove steeplechase and put in a nice overbank turn and a double reverse banking hill. I think it's probably the second double reverse banking hill, because of course the first one was on Wicked Cyclone at Six Flags New England, because it was mentioned in that announcement trailer when it was announced, the world's first double reverse banking hill. Bad Six Flags voice, I know, but I definitely love to see elements like that, especially that outer edge turn at the top of the lift hill around the tower. That is just iconic. And, I think Big Dipper would be a brilliant way to utilize those kind of elements. The next oldest is the Nickelodeon Streak, formerly known as the Roller Coaster. This opened back in 1933, a length of 2,293 feet, a height of 61 feet, a speed of 35 miles per hour, and a duration of 1 minute 44. The lift hill and other parts of the Velvet Coaster was used in the construction of the roller coaster, and it was built once again by Charles Page. Now, again, the Nickelodeon Streak is an interesting one because you've got to think of the rest of the area. You got to think, obviously, it runs past the Blue Flyer at one point, at a couple of points, sort of down one of the out and back parts of the layout. Obviously, around the old Space Invader building, goes towards Steeplechase. Can see the views of Steeplechase as well. Again, would Steeplechase have to be removed for this? Maybe, possibly, who knows? They could work it round it. Again, utilize that lift hill. And I'd like to see, now this might be a long shot, but I reckon you could do a barrel roll drop. Now, if you don't know what one of those are, you've seen it on Medusa Steel Coaster at Six Flags Mexico, Twisted Timbers at King's Dominion. So I reckon a barrel roll drop would be absolutely lush on this ride. Now, of course, there are other elements you could include. Obviously, you've got the hill element. So again, you could do a nice zero-G roll to replace a couple of those hills. Obviously, the turnaround round Steeplechase, we could see maybe a nice overbank turn in there. Obviously the brake run, obviously that's going to be quite a quick turnaround, so I'd like to see maybe and this might be a long shot, this gives me vibes of Colossus at Thorpe Park with the ending, maybe that last turn into the brake run could be a turn and then you literally bank into a straight up barrel roll into the brake run, a last inversion kind of thing. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think it'll be the first RMC conversion in the world to have a barrel roll finale. I could be wrong, but you never know. If you want to see examples of that, like I said, Colossus at Thorpe Park, or if you took the barrel roll at the start of Hydra at Dorney Park, the B&M Flawless Coaster, and put it at the end, that's what we're looking at here. But I think a barrel roll ending would be great. Obviously, in terms of names and themes, I didn't go through it too much with the Big Dipper in terms of names and themes, because I think the Big Dipper should be kept as the Big Dipper, or like not rename it the new Big Dipper, but keep it as the Big Dipper. But I definitely think with the Nickelodeon Street there is room for a new name and theme. Still with the Nickelodeon Land, if the area is still going to be Nickelodeon Land for a good few years, if this happens. I would like to see it go through kind of like the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Shellraiser treatment, and I'd like to see that kind of theme go in there, or a Nickelodeon Hellraiser, Nickelodeon Streak Hellraiser, that kind of thing. But I think a general Nickelodeon theme would be great for this RMC. It would be the first Nickelodeon or IP-themed RMC coaster in the world. Obviously, excluding the Raptor, so it would be the first RMC conversion in the world to be themed after an IP. And I think overall, I think the Nickelodeon Streak has room for ginormous potential. Finally, on your list of RMC's conversion possibilities, it's Grand National, opened back in 1935, a Mobius coaster with a length of 3,302 feet completely, a height of 62 feet, a speed of 40 miles per hour, and a duration of 2 minutes 20. Built by Charles Page, and of course an interesting fact about this ride is that back on the 20th of May 2004, a fire destroyed the Grand National Station and damaged two nearby rides, Trauma Towers, which is now no longer operating, and Alice's Wonderland, the dark ride, the classic dark ride with the I've Got a Golden Ticket. Ticket soundtrack. Now, the Grand National reopened on the 28th of October after repairs were completed. And of course, they used the water from the river caves and Valhalla to clear the fire. Very interesting fact there. Now, with the Grand National, again, this is the roughest of the three wooden coasters, in my opinion. And I think this is the one with the most potential. And I think this is the one that everyone's crying out for. RMC Grand National. And I did see, I was watching a video. And to be fair, Alan Shilkey, or one of the people at RMC, said to this person about a Grand National when they brought up in a conversation that it could be done. So it's definitely very exciting stuff. It could actually be done if Blackpool made the call in the future. But again, there's so many creative possibilities with this. The racing aspect, keep it. Look at Twisted Colossus 65 Magic Mountain. Look at how one track does like a little bumper airtime hill while the other track does like a nice stalled zero G roll. And then a straight up zero G roll from the other track that did no inversion first, as the other one goes sort of over as like a hill kind of thing. So many creative racing elements that could be added to this particular roller coaster. Obviously, you've got a choice with this one. You could go full dueling like the current Grand National is. You could go with that racing aspect. Or you could do the Twisted Colossus routine and go for the sort of two trains racing against each other, one waits in the station, and you got one rating to go on the brake run after the run, and it's literally two tracks combined into one. That could be the route that could go down and turn it into one station. I personally think they won't do that. I think they'll keep the station as it is, give it a nice fresh look to it, and I'd like to see it kept as a dueling coaster. I think it'd be a really good, it'd be Europe's first dueling RMC hybrid coaster, or the Europe's first dueling iBox RMC coaster. And I definitely think that with the support structure, I think they will get in some brand new support structures maybe. I think the support structure on Grand National could be described as iffy at times, but I tell you what, I think if it's still possible to hold top of track from RMC, fair play. They could go top of track if they wanted to. If the supports could balance it. But if not, they'll go iBox, they'll bring in some new supports as well. So I think the Grand National would be great in terms of the potential of this, and I think that a nice dueling RMC racing wooden coaster would be perfect to bring the nostalgia of the Grand National racing aspect back to the theme park. So there we go. That is my RMC Element predictions for Grand National, Big Dipper and Nickelodeon Streak. If they decide to get the RMC treatment in the future from Blackpool Pleasure Beach and Rocky Mountain Construction. Now, of course, now it's time to end the video by rating which of them is likely to happen. Straight away, first Grand National, second Nickelodeon Streak, and third Big Dipper. Literally, that's my order. It's straight up. Big Dipper is the least likely to happen. Nickelodeon Streak, I think, could happen with a Nickelodeon theme, but we'll see. Grand National's the most likely to happen because it needs the most work. Now, I know what some of you are going to be thinking. Forget RMC, what about GCI? Well, I think that, to be honest, I was debating whether that's a video worth on its own. If you want to see that on a video its own and we go into detail about the GCI track, comment down below. But in my opinion, I think GCI could just track it up in a few places and just make it smoother. I think that's not really worth its own video, but if you want to see my own video on that, then comment down below. And if you want to see me comment on which track sections on each wooden coaster you want me to see retracked by GCI with the Titan track. But I think that overall, I think it don't really deserve its own video. I think overall, they'll just retrack it in a few places, but that's about it. I think the RMC one did deserve its own video, so thank you very much, guys, for watching this video. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. And for now, my name is Coast Shell, Caitlin the Coast Life. And I'll see you guys next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have an RMC-tastic day. RMC, RMC, we want an RMC-tastic day.